a little game of hide and seek. If you wanna have some fun. Hey gems! Today I'm gonna be doing my Q&A that I asked you guys to ask me questions in my What I Got for Christmas video. You guys asked some questions, I am here to answer them, so let's begin. First question is, what were some must-haves when you were building your house? Amazing question, and I get this a lot actually from like friends and family. When we were building our house, obviously I needed it to be handicap accessible because I am in a wheelchair. And a lot of the things that I needed for my house was just very open space. Big doorways for my wheelchair to be able to get through because I'm a big girl and I have a chair. So I needed something that was very open and I wanted it to flow really well. So, and I think I achieved that. Some of the things that I really wanted in my house because I felt like because we were building a house, this was my one time that I could get pretty much everything I needed, so I wanted to do it in one fell swoop. My biggest one was my kitchen. I wanted to make sure that the cabinets were cut out underneath, so we had cabinets built all along the tops. If you guys have seen my cooking videos, you'll see that I have tons of cabinets on the top. I also have pull down drawers for the cabinets, and all of the drawers and cabinets they pull out. So if you guys would like a kitchen tour, I know you guys have been asking me for years for a house tour. I don't know if I'll ever actually do a full house tour, but if you guys would like a kitchen tour, please let me know in the comments and I would absolutely do it for you. So space, big doorways, open floor plan, no carpet, because carpet and wheels, they just don't mix. And we do have carpet in some of the bedrooms, but most of my house is hardwood floors. We love entertaining as well, so that's why we wanted a really open floor plan so we had space for lots of our friends and family. Also, we wanted to do a theater room downstairs in our basement because we love watching movies and having movie nights, and we achieved that and I absolutely love it. Next question is there a specific song or album that has a lot of significance to you? Absolutely. My number one album of all time is Three Cheers for Sweet Revenge from My Chemical Romance, specifically I'm Not Okay. It is my favorite song, it is my anthem. My favorite band is My Chemical Romance, and I have three My Chemical Romance tattoos, which I am gonna get into. There is a question about my tattoos, so I'll explain more about that later. But that album came into my life at a very, very specific time, and it was when I was in college. I was going through a lot of different emotions and feelings and trying to figure out who I was as a person for the first time on my own. And that album came along and it just spoke to me, and it still does. I absolutely love that. The I'm Not Okay song, which is on that album, it just signified a lot in my life at the time, and it's still my favorite song. It is the song I listen to when I'm in a good mood, when I'm in a bad mood, when I'm in a sad mood, any kind of mood I am in, I can listen to that song and it just automatically gets me hyped up. As soon as I hear that first guitar riff, I am just smiling from ear to ear. If you could spend a day with a celebrity, who would it be? Hands down, either Gerard Way from My Chemical Romance, Adele, or Robert Downey Jr. maybe? Maybe one of those three, because I'm obsessed with all three of them. Next question is, if you woke up tomorrow and all your makeup was gone, what would be the first thing you would go out and get? That's tough. Oh my God, I couldn't imagine if all my makeup was gone. That would suck. I think the first thing or things I would go out and get is just my staples. So foundation, concealer, mascara, if I had to choose like one eyeshadow palette, it'd probably be the Morphe 350 palette just because it's so versatile. Or it would be maybe one of the chocolate bar palettes from Too Faced. I love those as well. Yeah, it would probably just be a foundation if I had to do drugstore. I've really been liking the Rimmel 25-hour foundation. Actually, that's what I have on today, and I really do like that. My NYC eyeliner, my Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara, and the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer, or the Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer. Those are some of my favorites. This is a two-part question. The first one is, what is your favorite food to make? Really good question. I love to bake. I love to make sauces. That's
kind of sounds weird, but like Alfredo sauce. I make a peppercorn sauce that is to die for. The guys and that, the guys meaning Kyle and Tyler, the guys that live in my house. Tyler is my best friend and Kyle is my fiance. They love that. Anything I make, they love, which I'm, you know, makes me happy. But I really do love to bake as well. Actually, tonight I'm going to be making a chocolate lava cake, which I'm really excited about because it sounds amazing and I haven't made one in a really long time. So that's probably why, because it sounds good and I am, it's that time of the month, TMI, I don't care. I'm craving some chocolate. I need some chocolate in my life. So that's what I want to make. And the second part of that question is, what is my favorite restaurant? Ooh, that's a tough one. Probably Miserape. It is a Mexican restaurant in the city that I grew up in. We go there all the time. It is so amazing. Every single person that works there knows me personally because we go there so much and we always have like a designated table. So it'd probably be Miserape and it is really good. This one is a three-part question. First one is, have you ever been to Upper Michigan? If so, where? Yes, I have. I've been to Mackinac Island many times as a kid and we used to vacation up there all the time. Third part to that question is, have I ever thought of living anywhere but Michigan? Yes, I've thought about it. I've lived in Michigan my entire life. I have traveled to many, many different states in the United States as well as Canada. I would move to England, hands down, tomorrow if I could. I would. As for the United States, I don't know. I don't know if I actually would live anywhere but Michigan. I really do love this state and it's just, it's home to me and there's so many places in the state of Michigan that you can go where it doesn't even feel like Michigan anymore. Like I said, Muskegon is my favorite place in the world and I did do a vlog and I'll put a link here as well as in the description box for you guys so you can go ahead and check it out if you want to see that video and see where my favorite place in the world is. Alright guys, so this next question is pretty much at least 50% of you guys who asked me questions, this was what it was, is why did you get a tattoo or asking all about my tattoos. As I said in one of my other videos that I just posted is on February 6th, I'm going to get my, not my last tattoo by any means, but my tattoo that I don't have finished right now, I'm going to get that finished. And as soon as that heals, I am going to be doing a tattoo video for you guys. You guys ask me all the time about it. But the reason why I got tattoos is because I wanted to. I've always wanted to get tattoos since I was probably about 13 and I got my first one at 21 and I just pretty much haven't stopped for the last 10 years. So I love tattoos. I think that, you know, doing anything to your body that makes you happy, as long as you're not hurting yourself, go ahead. It's self-expression. That's the biggest way I can describe it, is it's self-expression to me. It's art. It's the only art that I can carry with me everywhere I go, and I can talk to people about it, and I can't lose it, and it's something that I can take with me all the way till my last day, which hopefully isn't for a long time, but when that day comes, I'm taking them with me. This next question actually really kind of gave me a little bit of a laugh, but I absolutely loved it. And it is, if you like the Santa Claus movies and you like Tim Allen, did you ever see the show Home Improvement, and who is your favorite character? I used to watch Home Improvement all the time, especially growing up, and then when I went into the hospital, Kyle and I watched it every single night because they played it on Nick at Night, and yes, I absolutely love it. My favorite character was Jonathan Taylor Thomas. I used to have a huge crush on him. I also loved Al, and I loved everybody in the whole show. It was such a funny show, and I'm sure that you can watch episodes on YouTube now. If you just look up Home Improvement full episodes, I'm sure there's millions of them, or tons of them at least. Next one's a little random, but I love answering your guys' random question, and it is, what is your favorite ice cream flavor? Probably cookies and cream. I like Oreos and I like ice cream, and when you put them together, it's a magical, magical experience. So there you go. Next question is, what are some of your goals for 2017? Now, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, this start of this year, the entire month of January, has not been the best for me. Basically, a few weeks ago, we found out that our dog Tabby has cancer. She has carcinoma, and we are starting treatment for her this week, And it's something, if you guys follow me on the Enstrom's Facebook page, I definitely talked about a little bit. It was absolutely devastating to hear this news because she is like our daughter. Both of our dogs are like our children because we don't have children yet. So my number one goal is to take care of Tabby. We are starting treatment and she is going to be having surgery to remove the cancer mass and a lymph node that it has gone into. I was thinking about actually doing a whole video on it, or basically just kind of like an update of what's going on in my life kind of video, but I figured I would talk about it right now. It's hard to talk about still. We're still trying to figure everything out. She's only 6 years old. She's an American Eskimo. And she's the sweetest little girl in the whole wide world. And for something like this to have to happen to her, it was really, really hard. And it still is very hard. But we are going to try to do everything that we can. We're hopefully going to be able to start her on chemo. I have actually thought about starting a GoFundMe page for her because the treatment and the surgery is extremely expensive, and it's just, it's going to be really hard. But my main goal for 2017 is to get her better or to enjoy the time that we have left with her. We're not really positive of the outcome of what is going to happen. We're hoping that with the surgery and with chemotherapy, she will be able to stay with us for a few more years, but it's not guaranteed. So yeah, that is one big thing that is the reason why I haven't been filming as much lately. I haven't been as active on social media as of late. And if you guys follow me on the Enstrom's Facebook page, I did talk about it a little bit. Also, it's just something that is very difficult for me to talk about because she's my daughter and I hate seeing her in pain or suffering. Luckily right now, it doesn't really seem to be affecting her personality or her energy level, but it's just something that has hit our family very, very hard, and we're just trying our best to do what's best for her. So anyway, some of my other goals for 2017 is definitely growing my channel, spending time with friends and family, and trying to make YouTube my full-time job, and just really creating exciting content. And I know I just talked about something that definitely was not exciting, but I do plan on filming so much for you guys this year, and I just can't wait for you to see it. All right guys, so enough with the sad times. Let's continue to be positive and everything like that. So next question is, what limited edition makeup item were you super bummed that you either missed out on or regret not buying? Whew. The Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette, that was one that I was super bummed that I missed out on. And the Jaclyn Hill face palette from Becca. Those are the two that I can kind of off the top of my head think of. If you guys saw my Best in Beauty 2016, I talked a lot about Jaclyn Hill and how much I love her products. But I know that she is coming out with an eyeshadow palette sometime this year as a collaboration with a brand. So I'm super excited about that, and I will definitely try my best to get my hands on it. So the next question is actually, why am I in a wheelchair? I've talked about this a lot on my channel, but if you're new, the reason I am in a wheelchair is because I have a spinal cord injury. I suffered my injury in October of 2008. And I had a MRSA infection in my spinal cord, and that is why I'm in a wheelchair. I do have a video talking all about my spinal cord injury, how it happened, when it happened, everything that I went through. It is a very old video, but I will link it in the description box below for you guys. And I do plan on doing an update on that video very soon. So if you guys are new and didn't know, I am in a wheelchair. I've been in a wheelchair for 8 years now, and yeah, it's just part of my daily life. At what age did you become a serious makeup lover? Honestly, when I was 27. I'm 31 right now. So I've only been into makeup for right around 4 years, and it's just something that I kind of fell into. I absolutely loved it. When I was a kid, I was a major tomboy. I had super short hair. You couldn't get me into a dress if you tried. And yeah, I don't know. It's just, I started watching makeup videos and I was like, this is really, really cool. And I really liked it. And I just started experimenting with different makeup and different looks. And this is the end result. There you go. I think it turned out pretty good. Next is another question I get a lot, and it is, what is your favorite eye makeup remover brand, or what product is it? If you guys just saw my empties, I love the Neutrogena Ultra Light Cleansing Oil. That is all I use to take all my eye makeup off with. It works great. It's from the drugstore. It's affordable, and it is incredible. I've been using it probably for about a year now, or maybe actually a year and a half, and I freaking love it, and it's the only one I will buy. Another question that's kind of about the tattoos is how many tattoos I have and which one is my favorite. I'm not going to tell you guys my favorite one in this video. I will explain all of them in detail and show you each one of them in detail in my tattoo video, but I do have 10 tattoos. Yes, I'm planning on getting more, but right now I have 10. What is my favorite highlighter to use? To date, I have Soft and Gentle by MAC on, and lately that's what I've been gravitating towards. I absolutely love it. It's so incredible. I think it looks absolutely beautiful on the cheeks. And if I had to pick out of all of my highlighters, which one would be like my staple, if I could only have one highlighter, it would probably be Soft and Gentle by MAC. What are some of my drugstore must-haves? If you guys missed it, actually, I did do a top 10 drugstore video. I will link it in the description box below. But some of my favorites are the NYC Liquid Liner, the Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara. I love the CoverGirl True Blend Foundation. The L'Oreal True Match Powder is fantastic. The NYC Smooth Skin Powder is fantastic if you like a loose setting powder. And NYX Matte Lipsticks. What is your go-to lipstick color? Red. A blue-based red. So many people ask me what my favorite red lipstick is. I am going to do a top 5 favorite red lipstick video, but my favorite go-to red lipstick is NYX Alabama in their matte line. It is super cheap. It is a gorgeous blue-based red, which works well for my skin tone, and I should have worn it today, but I'm not. What am I wearing today? I'm wearing a ColourPop in More Better. Another beautiful color, but my go-to is a blue-based red, specifically NYX Alabama. The next one is, do you have an idol, or who is your idol? Absolutely, Adele. Plain and simple. I love Adele. She is my idol. I love everything about her. I love everything that she stands for. You know, she is just one of these powerhouse women that doesn't take any shit from anybody, doesn't let the media dictate her weight or how she feels about herself. She's a very private person when she's not on stage. I did get the privilege to go and see her live this past year in September of 2016 with my sister, and it was just an absolutely amazing night. She was so funny, and I just look up to her so much. Now, if we're looking at idols for like YouTube specifically, Zoella, Pixie Woo, really just powerhouse women that tell it like it is, don't hold anything back, and just let their personalities completely come through. That's what I always try to do with my channel. I always try to let my personality shine through so you guys see exactly who I am. So if we ever get the chance to meet in person, I'm exactly in person who I am as I am on camera. And I'm just, that's just who I am, and I hope you guys enjoy it and like it, and yeah. This is a Harry Potter themed question because I like Harry Potter. Part of my collection you can see over there. But the question is, which of the Harry Potter books is your favorite? Also, which of the movies was your favorite? Half-Blood Prince for both. I absolutely love them. I love Slughorn. He's one of my favorite characters. I also love Lupin. Lupin is my favorite character, I think, in the entire series. But yeah, Half-Blood Prince is definitely my favorite movie and my favorite book. Also to you guys, if you are interested in seeing a video all about my Harry Potter collection, please let me know in the comments. I've been thinking about doing one for a while now. And I finally do have my collection all set up how I want it. So if you guys want to see that video, please let me know in the comments and I'll film it for you. This next question actually was pretty cool, and it says, if you could leave on a vacation tomorrow, what would you pack and where would you go? Well, I'd have to pack all of my medical supplies and my medications and everything for my chair and comfortable clothes. I would definitely want to take my dogs. I'd have to pack my makeup, which would be super hard, but I probably could do it. But where would I go? I'd go to the UK and I probably would never come back. I'd definitely take my camera because I would still want to film videos for you guys and tell you where I was going, but I would move to the UK. That's where I would go. What are some of your favorite things to eat? Whoo! Well, as you can tell, I like to eat. I'm a big girl and I like food. If you don't like that, that's your opinion. But I like to eat. Some of my favorite things, I love fruit. Strawberries particularly, I absolutely love. I love bread. I love potatoes. I love cheese. I love green beans. I love fresh green beans when they're grilled in a grill pan. Oh my God, they're incredible. I do love steak. I love turkey. I don't know, I love food. And, you know, I love everything a lot, except I'm not a huge vegetable eater. I do love carrots. I do love green beans. And I love artichokes. Actually, artichokes are so amazing. But yeah, so I like a lot of different stuff. Did that answer it? I don't know. Hopefully it does. Next one I've kind of already answered is, what is your favorite lipstick of all time? Shade, brand, anything like that. NYX Alabama Matte Lipstick is my fave. Second to last question is, what inspired you to continue your YouTube channel? You guys, plain and simple, it is all about you guys. Now, I know that I'm coming up on my fourth year on YouTube and I'm still at, you know, 3,000 plus subscribers. And I know a lot of people who come on YouTube at, by their fourth year, they're already in like the tens of thousands. But I'm still, you know, in the 3,000s, which is fine for me. I do this because I absolutely love it. I love it because of you guys. You guys are so supportive. You are so understanding. You're always there for me. You always understand if I can't post a video this week or I'm falling behind on it because of other things that are going on, whether it's my personal life or my injury or I'm in too much pain to film or anything like that. You guys are always there for me. You guys crack me up in the comments. I love when we're just talking and it's so positive. That's the biggest thing, is the positivity on this channel is so incredible. I would love to have more subscribers, so if you guys want to share this video or any of my other videos and get your friends talking about it, I would really appreciate it. But it's you guys. I love making videos for you, and I love that this is a very creative outlet for me. I need something to let my creativity and my personality shine through, and this is just the perfect way to do it. And the last question for this Q&A is, what are you most passionate about currently? A lot of different things. Like I said, I am very passionate about my YouTube channel, my friends, my family, getting Tabby healthy and keeping her comfortable, and just life. Even though I'm going through a lot right now and it's taken a big toll on our family, I'm still trying to think of the positive. That is what I've always done in my entire life. And creating amazing content for you guys this year, it's something that I am very, very passionate about. I really want to take my channel to the next level, hopefully this year. I'm really hoping we hit 5,000 or 6,000 or 7,000 subscribers this year. And I just have so much that I want to give you guys and show you guys. So that is pretty much it for the Q&A this time. If you guys want to do more Q&As, please let me know in the comments. I absolutely love answering your guys' questions and letting you know more about me. Also, I am bringing back Wheelchair Wednesday very, very soon, and I would really like to do a wheelchair-specific Q&A. So if you guys have any questions for me about life in a wheelchair, what it's like from my day-to-day, personal questions, as long as they're not too personal. I am an open book when it comes to my injury. So if you guys have personal questions, please leave them in the comments, Facebook message me, tweet me, Instagram me, anything you guys want. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Also, the winner of my giveaway that I did for my What I Got for Christmas is Ziggy Joe, so congratulations. I really hope that you enjoy your prize. Please get back to me within a week so I can send your prize out. And also for all of my winners from the Jingle Jumps December videos, thank you for being understanding. Like I said, this month has not been the greatest for me in my personal life, but thank you so, so much for being understanding. And we are still waiting on one more winner to get her prize. So if she does not contact me within the following month, I will be choosing another winner. So Ziggy Joe, I really hope that you enjoy your prize. And please, please, please get back to me. Send me a message on Facebook, on the M's Gems Facebook page. All my social media links are listed below, so you guys can go ahead and come over and say hi. So if you enjoyed this video and you're still liking the good old Q&As, give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit that little red button below. Subscribe, become a member of my M's Gems family. I love you guys so, so much, and I'll talk to you in my next video. Goodbye.